led by the Spirit. We'd like to be in the Lord's will tonight. Means much to be here, will. Means much to know what we're talking about.
Amen.
I've never claimed to know everything, but what I know, the Lord taught me.
All right. Amen, brother.
And I'll take his word over anybody, any day.
Amen.
If you want to look in the book of Exodus in the third chapter, I'd like to read through this from the good word of God. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Are you glad to be in the house?
Amen.
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 Praise
Amen.
The Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
I'm glad to be here. I'm glad to be here. You don't have my room, and I'm not here all
week.
But I've had my room, and I'm glad to be in the house of God.
Amen.
The Lord has brought me thus far.
Amen.
And he has brought you thus far.
Amen.
And he'd like to take us all away if we let him.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. I'm going to be careful tonight and do everything the Lord will have you do, and I don't want to go beyond.
Amen.
If I go too short, then I'm not fully obeying. If I go too far, I'm not in myself. Bible reads this way. Now Moses kept the flock of Jethro, his father-in-law, the priest of Midian, and he led the flock to the backside of the desert and came to the mountain of God, even to Horeb. And the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in flames of fire out of the midst of a bush. And he looked, and behold, the bush burned with fire, and the bush was not consumed. Moses said, I will now turn aside and see this great sight, why the bush is not burnt. And when the Lord saw that he turned aside to see, God called unto him out of the midst of the bush and said, Moses, Moses. And he said, here am I. And he said, draw not nigh hither. Put off thy shoes from off thy feet. For the place whereon thou standest is holy ground. Moreover, he said, I am the God of thy father, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. Moses hid his face, for he was afraid to look upon God. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. You know what I love about these stories? They're true stories.
Yes.
This happened.
Amen.
It's sure as you're alive, this happened.
Right.
But you ever think about a man like Moses? In his generation, he was the meekest man on the earth.
Right.
He was a meek man. A humble man. But he was a man that God had chosen.
Amen.
His birth. What he wanted him to do. And how life goes, and sometimes things maybe look like they work out a different way. And we wonder if something really is the will of God. And that's what I want to talk to you about tonight. We need to know the will of God. You say, what's that got to do with it? When God got ready to talk to Moses, he brought him to that point in his life. You know, he was raised up in the house of Pharaoh as a prince of Egypt. He had whatever he wanted. And the Lord had worked it out where his mama could raise him and take care of him. And God knew the Lord of that son just like the Lord. You know, the Lord was going to have to take him and use him. He still blessed his mommy and let her have the time that she had with him. Praise God. Children, when God works first.
Amen.
He doesn't make mistakes, and if he works man, an Egyptian, smite one of his brethren, and he kills him. And he hides the body. Thinking maybe that he's got it all hid from Pharaoh. Afterward, he sees two of his brethren fighting with one another. And he goes to stop them, and they begin to kind of like people do. He was just trying to keep them from doing wrong. And he said, "You going to kill me, my words, you're going to smite me like you did the Egyptian." And Moses knew then and there that the thing was known of Pharaoh. And 40 years old, he got up and he left for his wife. He fled a tall and lonely man of God. He fled for his life out into the wilderness. And he found his way down into the land of Midian. And he married a woman there. They started a family. He went to work for his father-in-law. And for 40 more years. See, God don't have to move overnight. God moves when God moves. God raised him up 40 years in Egypt. He's been 40 years out in the field.
Thank you, God. Thank you, God.
And for 40 years he worked and he learned how to be a shepherd.
Right.
Hello.
Amen.
He was in training. Right. He had to learn how to be a ruler.
Yes.
Then he had to learn how to be a shepherd. But when the day came and the time came, God knew in the day that Moses was born. Glory to God. That 80 years down the road, he would be in the backside of the desert land in the middle of nowhere, driving his father-in-law's sheep along. And he knew, "I'm going to set a bush on fire on the top of a mountain in the middle of nowhere so I can get Moses' attention."
Yeah, hell.
Isn't God amazing? Ain't God amazing? Praise the Lord. God don't work on my time. He knew the very hour and the very second Moses will pass by. When he made that mountain, Horeb, he knew the day Moses would pass by.
Amen.
And years earlier, he planted a seed on that mountain, and he had that seed grow into the bush that he could set on fire just to get Moses' attention. What will God do for you to let you know He will?
Amen.
God knew what it took to get Moses' attention. He knew what it took. He knew he had to get something that would catch his eye for him to notice. Something unusual. Because he had something he wanted Moses to do. Praise the Lord. God is amazing. God is amazing. Let me just change the night if I can. And praise the Lord will help me and just tell you, as I go along, God is amazing.
Amen.
He is absolutely amazing. To form that hill in the days and time to make it into a mountain. Because he had a man of God that he had to give his attention and show him something.
We'll praise the Lord.
We got folks that are going on goosebumps. They're going on what mama told them that they need to do. They're going on what some prophet would come and tell them. Maybe it's God's will. But Moses had to have his own experience with God. He was fixing to go and stand before the mightiest man, the leader of the most powerful nation on this planet at that time. And he had to know that he knew that he knew he was in the will of God.
Amen.
Are you in the Lord's will? Do you know what God wants you to do?
Amen.
How do you know that you're in God's will? You can't know what somebody else tells you. If it takes a burning bush that is not consumed to get you to understand the will of God,
Amen.
He had to know that he was in the Lord's will. If he didn't know, if God did not let him know for himself, he would have had many, many opportunities to doubt it out and stop and give up. But it means something to know you're in the will of God.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. I've read that many times, but when that God in my heart this evening, I begin to think, what about God?
Yeah.
That would work 80 years to bring just one man into his perfect will.
Yeah.
That would go in the middle of nowhere.
Right.
On the day, the minute, the hour.
Yeah.
And work a sign to show that man.
Right.
Get his attention so he can talk to him.
Yeah.
You know, sometimes things go on in life. Maybe God is trying to set a bush on fire.
All right.
Maybe God is trying to divide your attention.
Right.
And let us know some things.
Man.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Praise
the Lord. I'm here.
Come on, brother.
I sent my angel down. My spirit is here. You can't come to me filthy. Amen. I want you to take your shoes off your feet.
Yeah,
the ground that you're standing on is holy. You're going to be gathered tonight.
Holy ground.
Oh, you know where you're sitting tonight? It's the holy place.
Amen.
That we've set aside for the holy God.
Amen.
Holy to you.
Amen.
Come on, glory to God. Glory to God. Praise the Lord.
Praise the
Lord. God needed a man he could depend on.
Right.
He needed one that was willing to go down and obey him, even when the enemy would come back with another sign to match what he was doing.
Come
on now.
Come on, brother.
Hey, Lord. What'd he say?
Hey, Lord.
Hey,
Lord.
to him. Became a servant. Right. What did Moses do? He fled from the forest. You can say whatever you want to say. And people will fight us on what we believe.
Right.
And I can read you in the Word of God.
Yeah, right.
That God's willing to stretch forth your hand and take you by the
tongue.
And willing and obedient to God. But physically, his force was still on. He still had his strength as a young man at 120 years old. God, I thought one time that the Lord told him to go up to the mountain, the same mountain that he spoke to him on. He's going to bring him back to this mountain. Have mercy. While they was at the bottom, he went on up. And for 40 days and nights, that 80 plus year old man fasted and spent time on that mountain. And God gave him his word. He had another encounter with God.
Amen.
I said he had another encounter with God.
Amen.
God began to write the commandments down. I am the Lord thy God. Thou shalt have no other God before me. Yeah. Lord, begin to fill in around us.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
God, it touched that man. And he put him on the
floor. Thank you, Jesus.
Sitting on the street, it's called straight. Quit a street lamp, God. You get in this, you'll be on the straight street too.
Amen.
Glory, glory, glory. Well, I've heard about this man. I've heard about him. He was afraid to go to him. Won't you pray for him? Lay hands on him and heal him. Boy, this man's persecuting your people. He said he prayed. Yeah, I made a praying man out of him. He had his own encounter. He had his own burning bush. He had his own encounter with me. And now I put him on State Street. I struck him blind so he could see my burning will. I struck him blind. I pounded him to the world. And now the extra interfere to get his attention. He had his own encounter. And you. Lord, you see me. And he laid his hands on me. And the Bible said that it was as scales. Fell off his eyes. And the Lord told him the things that he was suffering. But he knew when Saul was born. After all the life that he had lived, he brought that man up. Good Lord. He met him at the feet of the best teachers in Israel. He was raised at the feet of Gamaliel. The greatest, even now, the Jews are not one of the greatest teachers that was ever. And Paul, Saul, said in his feet, because God moved ahead and knew what was going to happen. He's going to persecute my people. But I'm going to meet him one-on-one. He's going to have his own encounter. He's going to be a chosen vessel. Come on, brother. Do you know you know the Lord's will? Do you know that you know the Lord's will? Some people run to God. God ain't got nothing to do with it.
Amen.
I said, God has got nothing to do with what you're doing.
Amen.
That thing is okay. Love our family. Lord. Y'all see things that's going on. Some of you don't. Some of you might. Think things are going to get a whole lot worse than what they
are.
Amen. It's already in works. These little things that's going on around here distracting all these folks getting all these children. While they're looking at that, they're working in the law books. They're looking in God. We're going to need a man that has had his own burning bush. We're going to need a man that's climbed up the mountain to look at our bush. We're going to need a woman that the Lord has struck blind. Has heard the voice of the Lord. We're going to have to go beyond what Mama said we'd be good at doing for the Lord. You step over into what the Holy Ghost has told us what to do. If a man didn't have his own encounter,
And the Holy Ghost was speaking and warning him what was going to happen. Either back then, well, I must have missed it. But how many times a night and a day that he spent in drifting, shipwreck. How often do you think back to that day on that road when that light shone upon him? And he heard the voice of the Lord.
Amen.
The Lord called him by name. He told him he is. You know, after the first whipping, let's be honest, you not had your own word of this, your own light shining your light. That's the first whipping. And when they stone you and leave you for dead outside the city, you're going to another occupation. He knew what the Lord wanted him to do. He knew what God wanted from him. What if he hadn't done with the Lord? Think of things that he wouldn't have seen. The miracles that the Lord worked in his
hand.
You know, the Bible said that the Lord worked special miracles through the hands of Paul.
Right.
But that was a man that had an encounter one-on-one with the Lord. He didn't go through the preacher to get it. He didn't go through the prophet to get it. But it was him and the Lord. Praise the Lord. How long has it been since you got away and it was just you and the Lord? Me and you, Lord. I don't need nobody else to tell me you're big enough. I need to know this is the point in my life. I need to know I'm at the crossroad. I got a choice to make. Left or right.
Come on, brother.
Which way are you? The point of taking tapes, right. Handkerchiefs from his body. In other words, he was counting, he had such an
anointing.
That's what he did.
Right.
That's where we get you. Because that man that got struck blind.
Right.
That God found. And along the way, the Lord began to teach him.
Amen. Come on, brother.
This was the end of my life.
Yeah.
At that point, there was no life. But God put it in there because it's called Paul to do it.
Amen.
Come on, brother. Thank you, sweet Holy Ghost. That's why we do this. I said this. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Everywhere you go.
I said it caused him.
Amen.
The people knew what it was that he knew. And they knew it was right. Because he did it and they saw the power of God. And they knew what he was doing was
right.
Amen, brothers.
Amen, brothers. I feel the Lord drawing this thing. You know, in the times when it's something that if you was to tell people, they find they know what you've done.
Right.
It's just something, I just feel the Lord. Lord,
I love you.
I'm waiting for my own burning bush.
Amen.
I'm waiting on that voice. That same voice that said, Moses. That said, Saul. I'm waiting on him to say,
Everyone, Lord.
moving Sunday.
Amen.
There was a sign that broke Sunday. The thing that I felt Sunday is the same thing that I felt. Do you know what that was? You know that was a sign that was done. Be careful when you're looking for one thing and the Lord's working on another. You know what she had? I believe she had a sunstroke, so she had some poison. And the Lord came out and healed her. Brother, that was a sign. And the same thing that was moving that night is the same thing that was moving. If he had told me. I'm going to tell you something. Boys, you get with me, you fall out with me.
Come on, Rick.
And I hope you're with me. I've carried this for a while. We need somebody that's been up there and seen it for hours. That's been there herself. I'm trying to be careful.
Okay.
You know what we need to do for what? Brother,
if you go,
go and search the Lord. The Lord, I need you. I need to hear from you. I want you to tell me what to do. Can I say this and not hurt me? This has kept us back in the corner too long.
Amen.
If people don't believe in this. And it's almost, I hope you believe what I'm telling you. This has had us back in the corner too long. Amen.
Come on, brother.
Amen. Same thing that moved. Mm-hmm. It's the same thing in the movie.
Right.
We just need somebody that'll go to that place. Amen. Go to that place. I see you tonight going to that place.
Amen. Amen, Jesus.
But you know what? Mm-hmm. Aunt George, somebody got to do it, you do it for Jesus.
Right. Amen. Do it the right way. Right. Amen.
Your dad preached to me. And he said somebody will do it. And do it for God.
Right. Amen.
Well, praise the Lord. I hope you see that shouldn't be that hard. They shouldn't be that fear on the back. See what I mean?
Right. Amen.
See what I'm talking about? They sent us back to the corner. Too long. If God's in, brother, let's get in.
Amen.
If God's not in, let's get in.
Leave it alone. Amen. Right.
If God gets in there, there won't be no more fear than if I got his father.
Right. Amen.
Well, I knew I was going this way, and I knew it wouldn't be one of
them. Amen, Jesse. Come on.
I've seen a burning bush for good in my time. And I know that the Word of God is still working. And I know the way it's still working.
Thank you, God.
And wait, don't change, brother. And never will. I'll tell you, the people something is still holding us for its head.
Come on.
I've been on the mountain.
Amen.
I've been on the mountain. I said, I've been on the
mountain. We're homeless people.
I said he didn't change his word for Jesus. He won't change his destiny.
All right.
He never changed the way.
He never changed the way. He ain't about to change it. Do you know you're in the will of God? How do you know you're in the will of God? How do you know you're in the will of God? How do you know? There'll not be no tension on that. The Lord put me where I'm at. You ought to have enough confidence in me. By this time, 8 years, Tim, 8 years, I've prayed and sought God. But you ought to have more confidence in me.
If you have, you need to pray, Lord, you teach me.
And you know what it takes to get through the thing? See, I'm a sinner. And the Lord has to handle me. God, I'm a sinner. Is that how I am? But He knows what it takes for me. And what it takes for me, it might not be that for you. But the Lord knows how to communicate to you. Whatever that you need to have, He needs to get the full cross to you. He'll do that. Because He knows how to do that, and you know after it's done. Moses knew when he came back off from Mount Horeb the first time. He knew when he came back down, he had just had an encounter with God. Paul knew when he left that day, blinded, even though he couldn't see, he knew he ran into Jesus Christ.
Come on, buddy.
Now, people, we need to seek the Lord. We leave our altar. When we leave, we know we've had an encounter. To teach us what to do. To teach us what to do. You know, I don't know what to say. You know what I'm saying? Get up there and get out of the way. So things ought to be said. And God ain't moving on it. Because there's any feeling in the church. But you don't be afraid of the devil.
Come on, brother King.
That's the truth.
Who's on the Lord's side? You said that Moses. Come back on Moses. Who's on the Lord's side? Then you don't have to be afraid. You don't have to be afraid. Any terror that comes by night. You hear this Bible? Hey, you don't have to be afraid of that. Don't let the devil come in and take over the service. My Lord have mercy. My God's greater than that.
Amen.
The little seeds that the devil tries to sow, just let them blow right on that church. Just guard the Jesus. Well, find yourself somewhere. Find an altar and say, Lord, I want my own experience. I want my own experience. Lord, did you come away from that? And you know when Moses came up on that mountain? Zipporah, his wife, she knew something. Heaven had a glow on that. Kim would know that you'd seek in a way that you come out of your room. Kim would know, she said, you must got a hold of the Lord. You got a glow on you. You can say, the Lord has told me to get my box and to take such and such place.
Right.
See, I thought we'd go get back home.
Come on.
Come
on.
Amen. And until then, be very careful. You be sure that they had a good bell on them. They couldn't look at it. And even Paul, look at that bell. In part, remain.
Come on,
you know, that still matter that Israel couldn't really look into the glory of God because they rejected Christ.
Right.
That's how people are living. Partially, you know, they only partially blinded. Why were they partially blinded? They still had the Word of God.
Oh.
But they didn't have the Word of
God. Right. Thank God. Glory, glory.
We got home. Thank God on earth. Oh, praise God on earth. We come out. I'll say, look at you. And you must have had a good prayer. You must have had a good prayer. You can come out. You say, the Lord, give me the Holy Ghost, Father. Devil fought me back more than that, but I finally went on in there and I stayed. And I got the Holy Ghost. And she could say, I believe you. And she looked at me. She looked at me. And I thought, tonight I got the Holy Ghost. My skin felt different. I've been saved before that, but the night I got the Holy Ghost, it's everything. But we need to do it. Go somewhere and say, Lord, go in your wallet, go in your closet, say, Lord, I need to see what money's worth. And I say, I need you, Lord, to let me know. Let me for myself to thank you. Because when you know what the Lord is doing to you, when adversity comes, and it will, you can bring back on that rock and say, my foot's on the rock. My mind's made up. My glory of the Lord.
Come on, buddy.
And you go in the house. didn't mean to bother y'all today. It was just about the church. I want the church to be a church. I want to be a church to all the needs. Junior is going. I'll never be on. Well, it might not be a blind church. It may not take a blind life to follow me. I need you to let me know for myself.
Come on, baby.
That you ever an offering in. Get in all the way. I don't do things for this evening.
No.
But this time it's just me and the Lord. I said, Lord, just let me feel you. Just let me feel you. That I know that you hear me. Just let me feel you. Amen. Amen. Come on, give me that. There's nothing wrong with that. In fact, we often be praying before we get in there. Pray, Lord, I don't feel. But that's what we need, Lord.
Right.
We need our own experience. That's what I'm trying to tell you. It may not, ain't everybody going to be servants.
No.
If people tell you, if you don't do it, you can't make it to heaven. That ain't gospel.
No.
That's right there. If you don't speak in tongues, you won't make it to heaven. That ain't gospel.
Right.
Come on, Brother Jim. I tell you what you need to do is you will make it. You need to find you a burning bush somewhere.
Amen.
It's going to get hard and it's going to get tough. It's going to get hard. It's going
to get hard.
Glory to God. All these times I'm praying to get out of the way. Glory to God. All these times these presidents are coming in for speeches and they're getting American flags. Come on. Come on. Today I saw my little picture of me. I didn't know what it was, and I thought it was just odd. So I went, oh. It was a Muslim prayer card. Come on, brother. All right, I got the other deal. I'm telling you the truth. You better find you a burning bush somewhere. You better find your only path to God.
Go get.